I like to solve problems. I just like to go at them. And if I make 10 mistakes, that's fine. I'll get those 10 mistakes out of the way, and I'll finally figure out what was the right thing to do. I'm a professor at UC Berkeley in mechanical engineering. I've always liked exercising. I walk everywhere. I never in the car. I started log rolling when I was 10 or 11. Like to play a little baseball with my son. I was diagnosed with cancer in November of 2014. After a long year and a half period of discomfort. And at one point I made like just a little graph, and it was just going down so quickly. I remember thinking, like, at this rate, I mean, I'm not gonna be alive in 3 months. The biopsy showed very extensive and high-grade cancer in my prostate. It had spread to lymph nodes and some nerves, part of my bladder and my bones. Started the hormone therapy the next day, and then chemotherapy right away as well.
When we found out that this was Andy's diagnosis, we knew it was bad. The first thing I was researching like crazy, are there any trials? I think the state of the disease was such that there was just nothing here.
And then through friends, we were recommended to MD Anderson in Houston. And Johanna did a lot of the legwork just making that happen. You know, I think if Johanna hadn't have been there to just help me through the logistics, among other things, it's too intimidating. I think the thought of traveling there, even that point, seemed daunting. But enough people encouraged us that we had to go once. I've come to really not mind traveling at all. It actually makes me feel like I'm taking things really seriously and doing everything I can. I had surgery there in June of 2015. Started my clinical trial less than a year after I had been diagnosed.
Andy received an immunotherapy known as ipilimumab, or Yervoy. It's a drug that temporarily removes the brakes off the T cells, which are the immune cells that help fight cancer.
And so here was this option of something that was pretty exciting. Yes, it was also a little scary because there are all these side effects, but we were all in. We just wanted to go forward and make it happen.
I was supposed to receive 4 doses of ipilimumab every 3 weeks. I ended up only getting 3 treatments.
Andy actually developed one of the most typical side effects from this immunotherapy, which is when the immune cells actually attacked his skin and caused a rash. However, Andy actually had one of the best responses we've seen with prostate cancer.
Dr. Sabuti said, you know, your immune system is suitably excited and we're not going to have this 4th dose. But they argued that it was not unusual. They were really learning how to do the dosing.
Andy is defying the odds. For patients like Andy, median survival would have been measured in probably 2 to 4 years. And I believe that this trial has changed that prognosis significantly. 1 year after he started his treatment, he texted me a picture of him and he's like, look, well, I'm 1 year out. And then I shared that with the rest of our team saying, this is why we do what we do.
Being included in the trial gave me a huge amount of hope. It's a year and a half later since the immunotherapy and I feel great. I'm active, although I've had a little bit of progression of my PSA. I'm grateful to have been on the trial, and I would do any other trial pretty much right away, given the opportunity.
Going through the immunotherapy and coming out and being without any kind of treatment for the last year has been for me a huge win. That's the other big piece of hope. There's breakthroughs all the time. It's amazing to me how quickly things change.
Immunotherapy is really going to be a new and long-lasting treatment for cancer. Given that the Cancer Research Institute's main objective is to promote the funding and understanding of immunotherapy, it seems like a wonderful thing and will ultimately change a lot of lives for the better.